Well, hello there, I'm Green Deane, and welcome to my 76th video here on EatTheWeeds.com, and I'm being accompanied by some crows this morning. Today you're going to need one of these, because we're going to talk about a mustard that brings its own salt to the table.
Well, before we head out to the beach, let's take a good look at this. This is called Sea Rocket. Yeah, and it's called Sea Rocket because its seed pods are like little rockets. I don't know if we can get a little better look at it here or not with this. There are actually two species that grow here. This is the lanceolata, which means lance-shaped, and you can see the leaves are quite long and narrow, but you can kind of imagine that they're lance-shaped. The other one's called edentula, and it has much broader leaves, and you'll see there's one place where I'll show you a comparison of the two different species. But this is in the mustard family, and it tastes like a mustard. It gives you a nose of a mustard, and it's a bit peppery. You can eat it as it is. I'll move that over. You can eat it as it is, or you can cook it in one or two changes of water, or steam it lightly. You can add it to greens, or use it for as on its own. You can eat them. The young shoots or the tips are excellent. Now sometimes they say these have an ether-like taste on the roots, but I've never encountered that at all. It just tastes like a mustard that's peppery to me. So here we have Sea Rocket. Very good plant to run into. And it doesn't tend to turn as red as other plants can being next to the sea. But we'll go out and take a good look at it. Well, I'm at the beach today, and the plant I want to look at is down there, so let's go take a look at it. This is where the plant I want to show you grows. Now, where does it grow? Well, you can see we have right in front of me, the rack line, the high tide rack line, and then we have the flood tide where it takes away the bank. Here's the plant we want to look at. Sea Rocket. Put myself down here. Sea Rocket. It's in the mustard family, and if you take a leaf off and you give it a bit of a taste, it tastes like mustard. Well, actually, it's got a mustard overtone, but it's very peppery. It is Cakile edentula. That's another old term, but notice we got ourselves a little sulfur, I think, fluttering around there. But you can take these, and it's called Sea Rocket because the seed pods, somebody thought at one time, looked like little rockets. Very fleshy, quite tasty. You can actually, here's a better example of some pod. Look at that, of a seed pod. As a matter of fact, one just broke on. You can chop these up and eat them as they are. You can steam them or boil them, get rid of some of this. Couple of changes of water to get some of the saltiness if there are, or you can actually just, or even if you're so inclined, to dry them. But they're quite peppery, and so you can also use them for seasoning. Now we'll take a look at a leaf right while we're here. Yeah. Hard to tell with my glasses on. There we go. There's a nice leaf. They have a leaf and a seed pod of the Sea Rocket. And actually there are several of them. They're found throughout most of North America, Central America, all along the coast, whichever coast you're on. There are some, this one in particular, this is the edula. You can cook this one, there's no problem. The Maritima, the maritime one, it sometimes gets bitter when you cook it. So you have to make sure which one you've got and how you treat it. But, you know, you have to check out your local plant. Relatives of this plant can be found just about everywhere, as you can find in North America, from Texas, the Gulf Coast, around Florida, up the East Coast to Canada, and of course up the West Coast. There'll be different species, but they're all just about used the same way. And notice it has a very characteristic mustard blossom, a little four-petal blossom. Very, very tiny.
about your nose and your palate tells you, this is the mustard.
What I want to show you, if the wind will let me and the body is not too bad, is we have two different species of sea rocket growing here right next to each other. Notice the thin leaves you have here and the nice fat fleshy ones you have here. Two different species. Among all the vegetables that you can get near the sea, the sea rocket, which is in the mustard family, is probably the one that boils up to be the most tender and flavorful. It really is quite nice, and it does a very nice job. And it's one of those that I really look forward to.
Now remember, food is always where the water is, whether it's fresh water or salt water. Now here on Eat the Weeds, let's itemize the sea rocket. We'll start with identification. It has leaves that are 1.5 inches to 6 inches long, about 1 inch wide, 1/2 inch wide to 1 inch wide. They're lance-shaped in one species. Whoops, I got myself a fire ant in one species. And they are oval in the other species. And each species has, the lance-shaped species has a few teeth on it, and the oval one has quite a few bumps on it. They're really not teeth, they're bumps. The flowers, that fire ant itches a bit. I hope that's the only one. Oh Lord. The flowers are a typical mustard flower. They're 4 petals, a little cross. They can be white or lavendish. And the seed pods are about 5/8 of an inch long and rocket shaped. Time of year. Well, most of the year here, further north, spring to fall. Environment. They like it just above the high tide mark, sand dunes, shore of that, but you're going to find them very, very close to the high tide mark, the rack line. Method of preparation, being accompanied by an osprey. Leaves, stems, and seed pods, raw, steamed, or boiled. It depends upon what time of year and which part you get and how much salt is in it. Older plants get tougher. Often when making a soup, I just take the tops of several of the plants and just toss them in the water and don't add salt. Now remember, the Maritisma species make it bitter when it's boiled, so you have to make sure which species you've got. Also, as a famine food, the roots have a soft outer part which can be scraped off, crushed, and added to breads and things like that as a famine food. Thanks for joining me here in my 76th video on Eat the Weeds. .com. If you want to learn more about sea rocket, you can go to Eat the Weeds and read about it and several hundred other plants. So until next time, this is Green Deane. I want you to think green, I want you to live green and eat green, and that includes the sea rocket. And sometimes if you cook it, you'll need some of this. Doodles. Now where did I get that fire ant? And they're not edible. Well, they are, but they're not too tasty.